What's up, guys, and welcome back to my channel. I thought I would talk a little bit about how to keep your immune system healthy or how to get it back to a healthy level if it's not there already. I think that having a healthy immune system is extremely important in good times and even more important in times like we're in right now. Before I get into it though, I want to make it clear that I'm not an expert on this stuff. I'm not a doctor. I'm not an expert on any of the stuff I talk about, and I make that clear in my videos when I share tips and stuff. This is just all information that I've gained over the years of being very interested in this, being very interested in health and fitness, and I've learned a lot of stuff from personal experience. But again, I'm not a doctor, so just keep that in mind as you watch this video. I do, however, think that the information I'm going to share in this video is important for people to know and is actually useful. Before I get into how to keep your immune system healthy or get it back to a healthy level, I think it's important to establish what a healthy immune system means. There's a lot of common misconceptions out there about immune systems, and there's a common phrase that I'm sure you've heard, boosting your immune system. And really that's not accurate. That's not really possible. It's not possible to boost your immune system. Your immune system is either healthy or not healthy. If it's healthy, there's no way to boost it to an even healthier level. If it's not healthy, there are steps that you can take to bring it back to a healthy level. If your immune system is healthy, there's no way to really boost it to an even healthier level. But there are things that you can do to maintain it at a healthy level. And likewise, if your immune system is not at a healthy level, you can do the same things to bring it back to a healthy level and then maintain it there. Really, the phrase boosting your immune system is created by vitamin companies to sell their products. And I'm a big advocate of taking a multivitamin, taking vitamins. I also think it's really important to get as many of your vitamins and minerals from natural sources like fruits, vegetables, stuff like that. But I also do think that there is some benefit to taking some of the vitamins that are sold. Vitamin C is a very popular vitamin for people to take to boost their immune system. And taking vitamin C on a consistent basis, so taking it like every day for long periods of time, can actually do more harm than good. It can actually hurt the bacteria in your intestines and your stomach, and cause stomach problems. And so if you do get sick, if you get a cold or the flu or something, your body doesn't actually have any extra vitamin C in its system. Zinc is another popular thing for people to take to boost their immune system, but it's in a similar situation as vitamin C. If you take it every day, it becomes your new normal in your body, and so it doesn't actually provide you any benefits to your immune system. But there is proof that if you start to feel sick, if you start taking zinc as soon as you start to feel sick, that it can actually reduce the length of your sickness, and it can reduce the severity of your symptoms as well. And I can link to some studies about that in the description below, and I can also link to studies showing the negative effects of taking vitamin C every day in the description. Once again, though, I'm not an expert, so if your doctor has recommended that you take vitamin C or take zinc every day, please listen to your doctor. If you're curious about this stuff, I would also highly encourage you to talk to your doctor about this stuff. There's absolutely nothing wrong with being curious about this and wanting to learn more, but I would encourage you to go to your doctor for more information. So what does a healthy immune system mean? Well, really, it just means that your immune system is operating at its normal level. And there are some steps that you can take to ensure that your immune system remains at its normal level, at an optimized level. And the steps are actually very simple and very straightforward. They're things like eating healthy, getting enough sleep, drinking enough water, exercising regularly, living a healthy lifestyle. And I'll get into a little bit more of the specifics of each one of those in a minute. But I think that if your immune system is weak for some reason, before you go out and start taking a bunch of vitamins or minerals or something to try to boost your immune system, which again is not possible, I think it's extremely important that you make sure you're living the healthiest life possible. And then if you're still having issues, go to your doctor. Sleep is something that actually greatly affects your immune system as well as just about everything else in your body. But for some reason, it seems to be an aspect of health that is so often overlooked. Even by people who are in amazing physical shape and exercise all the time and eat super healthy, for some reason, they don't seem to prioritize sleep like they do exercise and good nutrition. I think that if you're not getting enough sleep, then your immune system is probably much weaker than it could be. And I've made a video about sleep and what good quality sleep is and what enough sleep is, so I can link to that up here at the top of the screen, and I'll also link to that video in the description. But make sure you're getting enough sleep. It is extremely important. The next thing that I would encourage you to do to improve your immune system is exercise. And especially for the current pandemic, the current virus that we're battling with, getting some sort of cardiovascular exercise is especially good. In general, getting any sort of regular exercise is very good for your immune system. But for this particular virus, because it affects your lungs so much, having good, healthy lungs is extremely important to battle this virus if you do end up getting it. And the same thing goes for things like smoking or vaping. Those have huge negative effects on your overall health, but especially the health of your lungs. And right now, in a time like this, I think that it is extremely important to do anything and everything you can to maintain your health. Another aspect of health that is commonly overlooked, just like sleep, is hydration. Make sure you're drinking enough water. And I've also made a video about staying hydrated, which I can also link. But drinking enough water is essential for all aspects of health, everything your body does, maintaining a healthy immune system. So make sure you're drinking plenty of water. Now, if you do eat healthy, you sleep well, you drink plenty of water, you get regular exercise, if you're doing all of the things that you can do to maintain a healthy immune system, but you're still looking for some extra steps that you can take to really optimize your immune system, there are some things that you can do. There are certain fruits, certain vegetables that contain higher amounts of vitamins than others. Things like kiwis are great for your immune system. Blueberries, blackberries. Make sure you're eating a wide variety of fruits and vegetables, getting fruits and vegetables of all colors. Green leafy vegetables, spinach, kale are super good for you just in general, but they're great for your immune system. And once again, you can't boost your immune system, but eating certain foods like those will help to optimize your immune system and bring it to the maximum level possible. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, it would mean a lot to me if you hit the subscribe button down below and give this video a thumbs up. Like I said, I will link several studies on immune system health in the description down below if you want to check any of those out and learn a little bit more about this stuff. Again, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next video.